Hello friends, welcome back to our session. So in the previous session, we have seen the implementation of applet, a graphic class, font class and a color class. So in this session, we'll go with the one more topic, that is AWT controls. So there are several AWT controls available in Java. So let us list out them. First one is label, button, checkbox, checkbox group, choice, list, text field, text area, scroll bar. So these are the AWT controls available in Java. So with these AWT controls, we can also handle the events occurred with these AWT controls. For example, if you consider a button, if you press the button, an event will be occurred, and the occurred event will be handled by the corresponding listener interface. So which we have discussed in the previous session. So in the previous session we have discussed about the event handling, so event sources and event listener interfaces, right? So whatever the event occurred by using these controls, corresponding event listener interface will be responsible for handling all these events, right? So in this session, let us look about the two AWT controls. So how to create a label, how to create a button, how to make visible on an applet, right? So how to handle the events of these two things, right? Let us see one by one. So whatever the AWT control we are trying to create, just we will follow the template so that the programming will be very simple. First one, import the packages. So here the packages, mainly the first one is AWT package, which is responsible for graphics class, and applet package, right? So our applet programs, which we have discussed in the previous session, that every applet program is a derived class of applet class. So that's why we have to import the applet package as well as event, awt.event, because for handling the events, right? So first step, we have to import these packages. Second, and we are using the applet, we are creating the applet. So we have to enclose the applet code in the our editor, right? So we are not using any web browser. So we are using the applet tag inside the code. So write the applet code. And then create a class. So class which extends applet and implements interface, the listener interface that depends upon the event occur. And then we know that applet lifecycle, the applet program starts with the init method, so we have to write the init method. In this init method, we can set the background, set the foreground, and here we have to create objects of these controls and add these objects onto the container. So here the container is applet, right? Next, after completing this init method, automatically the paint method will be called. So we have to write the paint method. Okay, so and then if you are implementing the interface, we have to write the definition for the method which is available in this interface. So we have to write the code for the methods of interface. So we know that interface is a, it contains the abstract methods, that means only declaration, there will be no definitions. So if you implement this interface, we have to write the definition for all the methods available in this interface. So that we have to write it here, right? So this is a, just a template to apply the AWT controls, working with AWT controls, right? So first one, let us see. The first one is label. First one is label. We know that all these are the classes, right? So for creating the object, we have to use the constructor, right? So label object name L1 is equal to new label. This is a constructor, right? So for creating the object for a label, there are different types of constructors. So this is a constructor with zero parameters, zero arguments, right? So we can also create a label with parameterized constructor. So we can also use here label. You can pass the string as a parameter which will set as a label. So these are the two different ways to create an object for a label. One is without the arguments, another one is with arguments. And this class consists of two methods, that is getText and setText. Right. So getText is used to retrieve the label from the code. So and setText is used to set the label, a new label, that means a renaming. So if you use this constructor, here we are not giving any name. So by using the setText method, we can give a name for a label. Or if you use this one, here if you give here just like some ABC, and meanwhile, if you apply this setText method with called DEF, so ABC will be replaced with DEF, right? So these are the two methods available in label class. So here also, and it doesn't generate an event. It is just, it is used to display the content on the applet. So this AWT control is an exceptional case which doesn't generate any event. It's only for a display purpose, right? Next, we'll move with the second one, that is button. Button. So here button is also similar. So button is also a class. So here also, if you want to create an object, we have to use the constructor with the help of constructor. So I will give you that one, button. B1 is equal to new button. So this statement will create a button with a no name, because here we are not giving any name. So it will create a button without any label or without any name. And button B1 is equal to new button. Submit. So this will create a button with a label submit. So here also two types of parameters. One is without any parameter, I mean without any argument, and second one is a parameterized constructor. So here, whatever the text we are writing as a parameter for this constructor, that will be set as a label for the button. So here also there are different methods available in this button class, that is get label, set label. Get label is used to retrieve the label of a button, and set label is used to set the label. If already a name is given for the button, this will be replaced with the given parameter. And if you create a button in the first by using the first statement, you can give a label by using the set label method, right? And here also same, we have to follow the same template. So by using those templates, we can create a button. And for button, there is an interface called action listener, right? By using this interface action listener, these events, button events, will be handled, right? So we'll stop here, and let us see the implementation of this label and button in the system so that your doubts will be clarified.
Hello friends, so just now we have seen various AWT controls. So among that, first let us see the label, how the label works. So we know that a label is just displaying the text on the applet, and we have also seen the template need to be followed while implementing this AWT control. Just we will follow the template. So first of all, we have to import the packages, import java.awt.star, similarly import java.awt.event if you are using any event handling mechanisms or anything, we can use this event.star, right? And also graphics, import java dot, okay, for graphics we have already imported awt.star. Now we have to write the applet code. So applet code is equal to, so let us create the label demo. So label demo, fix the width is equal to some 600, height is equal to some 500, and close the applet and put these statements in comments. Yes, so first we are importing the packages, then we are writing the applets. Now we have to write the class, public class label demo. It should extend the applet, because all the applet programs are the subclasses for applet class. Extended applet, right? If you are using any event handling, we can implement that listener interface, right? So now let us create a init, public void init. So applet program always starts from the init. So init method, here we can set the background and set foreground. Background is equal to set background of color dot black. Next, set foreground is equal to, foreground color dot yellow. Then we have to create an object for a label. So label L1 is equal to new label of, so we have to give the parameterized constructor. We can pass the string which should be displayed on the label, right? So I will just display the label as branch. So branch is initialized to L1. Similarly, create one more object for a label, L2 is equal to new label. Give one more thing, that is college. Right. Now, after creating the objects for these things, now we have to add, right? So, add L1. Similarly, add L2. So, we are adding these objects to the applet. Now, write the paint method. Paint graphics G object. So, let us display G dot drawstring. We can give label demo. Right. Let us close this one. Save this as a label demo. Label demo dot Java. Now let us execute this one. So Java C label demo dot Java. So let us check for the errors. Yes, lot of errors are there. So cannot find the symbol. Okay. Yeah, we have to import java.applet class. Right? Now let us execute this one. I mean compile this one. Yes. So there is a one more thing, drawstring a string. Yeah, we have to pass the parameters where it should be displayed. 50 50. Right. Yes. So it was successfully compiled. Now we have to use the applet viewer tool for execute this program. Applet viewer label demo dot Java. Right. So if you observe here, so we have created two labels. One is for branch, another one is college, and we are just displaying the string at the parameters 50 of x coordinate and 50 of the y coordinate. So a label means it's displaying the text on the applet. This is called as label. It doesn't have any event handling, right? It is only for displaying the text on the applet. So this is all about the label demo, right? Now let us see about the one more component, AWT component, that is button, push button. See, first we will import the statement, import the packages. Right, this is for graphics class. Import java.applet. This is for applet. Import java.awt.event.star. This is for event handling. Now we have to write the applet code. Applet code is equal to, let us take it as a button demo. Width is equal to some 600, height is equal to some 500, and close the applet tag. Close the comments. Now create a class, public button demo, sorry, public class button demo. Extends applet and it implements. So we are writing the event handling also. Whenever the user clicks on the button, what should happen that event will be handled by the event listener. That is, so for button there is an action listener, that is the listener interface called action listener. Action listener, right? Now so first write the init method, public void init. So in this init, just we will set the background and foreground. Just we can leave by default, it will be the background color will be white and foreground color will be black. Now let us create a label buttons. Button B1 is equal to new button. Right here we can pass a string, that is the text which we want to display on the button. Let us take red. Let us create one more button. B2 is equal to new button blue. Let us create one more button. B3 is equal to new green. Right. So now we have created three buttons with the name red, blue and green. Now let us add all these things. Add B1. Add B2, add B3. Right? Now we have to add the listener interface. Right? We have to add the listener interface. Now for that we have seen B1 dot add action listener. So this we have seen in the previous session, right? Of this. B1 dot add action listener, add key listener for registering the events with the sources. So similarly B2 dot add action listener of this. B3 dot add action listener of this. See, first let us see just whether the button is displaying on the applet viewer or not. Public void, paint graphics g dot draw string button demo. I have to pass a parameters 100 100. Right. So let us close the class, let us save the class and let us check whether the button is displaying on the applet or not. Button demo dot java. Right, now let us execute this one. Java C button demo dot java. Yes. So here you can see the error, button demo is not a abstract and does not override abstract method action performed. So here in this program we are implementing one listener interface that is called action listener, in which there is one method called action performed. So here we are not writing any definition for that action performed, because this is an interface, right? So if you are implementing that interface, we have to write the definition for the methods available in that interface. So let us write the empty interface, public void action performed. So this is the only method available in action listener interface. So here with the help of class and interface we have to handle the event. So yes, this is just an empty definition, empty body. Now let us execute this one. Yes. So in order to execute this one, applet viewer button demo dot java. See, if you observe, so here one text is displayed on the applet and the three buttons are displayed, one with the red, blue and green. So here whenever the user clicks on the red button, no action will be taken. If a user clicks on a blue button or a green button, no action is to be taken, right? Because we didn't write any action to be taken in the action performed. So whatever the action the user wants to be implemented, that should be written in this action performed method, right? So if the user clicks on red button, that will be assigned to this object AE. Now see, string str AE dot get action command. So this is the method which is used to retrieve the label of a button, and it will assign it to the string, right? So AE dot get action command. If user clicks on red button, in the red button we have given a label as red, that will be assigned to string. If user clicks on the blue button, this blue will be assigned to string. If user clicks on the green button, this green will be assigned to string. Now we will check str dot equals. Equals is a method which used to compare, right, for string class. Red, it compares with this given label. If it is successful, we will just change the background color. Hope you understood this one. Background color, so color dot red. Again, if it fails, we have to write the one more condition, str dot equals. See, blue, sorry, then we have to set the background color as blue, and only three buttons are there. We can write that simply else condition. If both are false, automatically the third one will be the true. Background color dot green, right? See, right. So here, after clicking on the button, whatever the action we want to implement, that should be written in action performed, right? So whenever the user clicks on that button, the event source will be activated, and that will be implemented by using this action listener. So in that action listener, there is a one method called action performed, and whatever the logic we want to implement after clicking on that button, that should be written in this method. Right, if you click on that red button, that red background will be set to red color. So let us execute this one. So java c button demo dot java. Yes, next we have to use a applet viewer tool, button demo dot java. So there is a text and three buttons. If you click on the red button, the background color is changed to red. If you click on the blue button, the background color changes to blue. If you click on the green button, background color is changed to green. So this is the event handling, right? So previously we didn't write any code in this action performed, just we have written only the empty body. So no action is to be taken even though a user clicks on this button. Now we have written this to change the background color. So whenever the user clicks on these buttons, event will be handled, right? Yes. So for this we have to just follow the same template. First we have to import the packages, then applet code, write the applet code. Next class, write down the class which extends the applet and implements the action listener. Write down the init method. In the init method, first create the object for the different AWT components, and then add those AWT components to the applet, and then add action listener, add key listener, right? That means register the event listener to the events, and then write down the methods which are available in listener interface which we are implementing. So we can follow the same template, so that will be very easy for coding, right? So hope you understood this one. So in this session we have seen two AWT components, that is label and button demo. And once again I'm repeating, for label there will be no event generated, that is only text displayed on the applet. For the button there will be an event that is handled by the action listener interface, right? If you are having any doubts regarding this applet or AWT components, feel free to post your doubts in the comment section, so that I will definitely try to clarify all your doubts. If you really understood my sessions, like my sessions, share my sessions with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for listening. Thank you very much.